Today is Saturday, May 14th. I'm going to be giving a very in-depth tour of John's Mini Golf 2016. This year we have 23 holes. John's Mini Golf has been going on for the past 6 years in a row. It's pretty mind-boggling thinking of that. It's been 6 years I've been doing this, especially the fact it's a new course every single year. This year we have a bunch of stuff from the floats and the Mifflin Lakes Canoe Carnival, just like little giraffes, hippos, snakes, and the clock over there. So let's just look at the opening desk. This year we are doing troop donations yet again. We've been doing those the past, this is going to be the third year that we've been doing that. So here's just the main desk. They usually would be, there should be business cards and like the score sheets there, but it was raining last night, so I just took them inside. Here's the balls, that's where you put the money, and then obviously there's the clubs right there. And this course, I spent this morning cleaning it up just for this video. The holes itself have all these like little pollen things on them. That'll take forever to get those off, so I just kept them on though. But I raked everything. It looks really nice. So this is hole one. Hole one has pretty much never changed the past 6 years. It's the same shape and everything like that. Just the rocks are usually like in different spots. Hole number two got interesting this year. It's usually just like a wooden like hollowed out log just like this, but I kind of wanted to change it a little bit this year. So once it goes inside the log, it comes down and just like goes down like steps right here and goes right into the hole. Hole number three, it's also been remodeled. Hole number three actually used to be like right over here, like in this little gap, but I expanded a little bit more this year. I pushed all these leaves back and put some sand down because this stuff was like pretty much like right there and like over here, like right there and like over here is like where it was. I just like kind of like pushed it back a little bit. So hole number three, go off the ramp, and there's like a little gap right here. And you want to try to hit it over like that little gap and not hit the posts. And hopefully it goes right in the hole. And then hole number four, you got to go all the way up here. The layout is a little bit weird, but that's all I could really do. That's when you go over a ramp and you try to get it to roll on top of this log. And then hopefully bounce off that brick or bounce off the brick in the back and go into the hole. Hole number five is pretty small. There was like this little tiny area over here, because I knew how to make room for this hole and whatnot. And so there's like a little tiny empty space. I could just put like a bench here, but I wanted like an extra hole. So I knew it had to be something small. So I did something like this. So it's a pretty small hole. Just go up the ramp into the pipe. Nothing too special. Hole number six is pretty much the same thing every year, but this year it's way different. It's like the big ramp as usual, but this time we have this big change. Usually it's just like a bunch of rocks and big sticks and stuff like that, like all in this area. As you can see, this is obviously the biggest hole in the entire course. I want this hole to be very, very long, and it's pretty long in my opinion. So what you want to do is hit the ball over that ramp, get inside this little box, and then you can tap it in to the pipe, which goes on, I call it the monorail. It goes onto here, and then through that pipe, and then into the hole. And there's also if you miss the jump right there, there's like rocks down here, the windmill. As always, I always have the windmill the past like 3 or so years I made that. This looks like a little stop sign. I think it's pretty funny. And hole number 7, pretty much hole number 7 is always made out of like wood, like firewood. It's never really changed. Nothing too special here, just go over the ramp and just a bunch of rocks and wood and whatnot. Yet another expansion happened this year. Usually like this wood just like continued like down like where the edge of this little slope is, because if you can't really tell from the video, this is definitely like on a hill. And so I really want to make something special over here. So I made this hole, and it's pretty much all green. You try to hit it from up there and hit off the back of the brick and then go into that, and then it'll go into the hole. And yes, there is steps as well. Just because how steep this slope is, you don't want some of the older people to fall and stuff like that. And those steps were actually not that hard. They were kind of hard to make, but not that hard. They're not like they're just like into the ground. Like I just put like the wood. There's like all this wood on the side is like kind of like a foot in the ground or so. But it's like really sturdy. Like when you walk on it, it doesn't like move or anything like that. It's pretty well made. Hole number 9. This used one of the canoe carnival stuff. Just go over this ramp and then hopefully just like run on top of this canoe. And then go in between these paddles, and then the hole is right there. And yes, there's like rocks and stuff like that on the sides. Hole number 10, nothing too special either. Off this ramp, a bunch of rocks, and then there's like this like concrete block you can go like in there. Hole's back there. Now, I'm pretty sure that was number 10. Yes, number 11 this year. Hole-in-one mania. Always gotta have the hole-in-one mania. It pretty much changes every single year, but it's always easy to get hole-in-ones. Never changes. So you just hit it from there, you go up this little tiny ramp, and then like cross the bridge, and then the hole is right there. Number 12 is the same exact thing, the same exact spot as last year. It's just like the three different pipes you go into. That one leads out on that side. That one goes into the hole. 13, also used from the canoe carnival stuff, this snake right here, which if you want to, you can plug it in and its eyes light up. And there's just a bunch of wooden posts all around. The hole's back here. This bench stayed in the same spot as last year. 14. I really like how I designed this hole. I had a bunch of leftover stones. Because as you know, I used a bunch of stones this year to pave, not pave, but just put down underneath the main like desk. And yeah, this one was just like on a curved angle. So like the ball would come down and just like swoop back up and into the hole. The trick to this hole is you don't even need to hit it hard at all. Just tap it really like lightly and it would just like naturally do its thing. Hole number 15, this is a very unique hole. This is a fun one too. As you can see, you stop there, you go up this metal, and it's like a hippo from the canoe carnival as well. And it goes inside the hippo and comes out the other end. Here's number 16. Again, canoe carnival, this big giraffe. Go up this ramp and into that hole. Hopefully you can get it in there. And then it rolls through this log and goes into the hole like pretty much every single time. 17 is just a bunch of different like big rocks. Like I didn't really use them towards the end of the holes, so I just wanted to like use the big rocks I had. 18, this is like funny story about this. This right here is actually my old mailbox, but somebody kind of backed into it and broke it, so I kind of used it as Vaughn Hall, and if anybody doesn't know what Vaughn Hall is, it's like pretty much like the community center in my town at Medford Lakes. It's just like, that's pretty much what it is, like a community like center. And hit it off here, go through Vaughn Hall, and the hole's right on the other end. And also there's like a sign that says Beach 1, because Medford Lakes has a bunch of beaches, and that was from the Canoe Carnival as well. Going number 19, this one's really fun. Go up this huge ramp and then hopefully get into like the middle piece of wood and just like roll down to the pipe, and it goes like throughout this huge thing right here that says John's Mini Golf on it, and then it goes right into the hole. And now hole number 20, the last hole. On the waterfall wasn't usually like flows better than that. It just wasn't really working this morning. I tried to fix it. So this is pretty much like one of the biggest renovations, I would say, out of all the holes. I pretty much kept this, the last hole's been a water hole for the past, I would say, I think it's been the past 4 years, including this year. So everybody loves it. Why should I change it, you know? Pretty much like the centerpiece of the entire course anyway, so. Usually, this whole beginning part is completely remodeled. It used to be like, all this way, he used to be held up just by like stacking wood like that. And that, over the years, I just like kept it here and didn't move it. And I got like, it would always be really uneven, and I couldn't really, it would just be really bad. So I have like a more efficient way, just like the wooden poles, and it doesn't move or anything like that. And it looks a lot cleaner than it did before. So again, the three holes, each one comes down on different sides. And then this one goes through the log. And then I'm gonna call this the jungle. Through the jungle and then like into the hole. As you can see, there's some like fish inside there. And yes, there's like various plants around here. I'm gonna get some more plants once it gets nicer out. And there's a big flag as well. And before I go over to like, before I go over to the last three holes, I'm just gonna show you inside like John's Mini Golf main office and the gift shop. So there's like a door right here that you can like latch on with this piece of chain if you want to. I want to get like a pretty much a good tour of this in here. So here's the gift shop. I sell a few things in here. I sell balls. Usually I put like, I get a Sharpie on the gold ones. I put like, I write John's Mini Golf and Sharpie on them. But I need to spray paint some more of the gold ones. Cause yeah, I spray paint the gold ones. I don't spray paint like any of my balls that I have like in the thing over there. Only the gold ones I spray paint. So this is where you put your money in there. And what this is like the insides of golf balls. Like I get branch cutters, and if you want, you can try it at home. Just get a golf ball, get some branch cutters, and you can just cut it open really easily. And that's like the colors of like the inside of them. It's pretty cool. And I also sell wristbands, John's Mini Golf wristbands. They're $2 each. This year I got like 200 of them. They're not all right here. Most of them are inside. This is probably like about 100 of them. All different color combinations. Pretty much every color that was on the website I have here. And then this was the original, if you don't know, this was the very original sign that was at the street in John's Mini Golf. Ooh, might have been 11 or 12, that original sign. These are just from past years. And these are the flags for the holes in 2013. No, I think it was 2014. Just some stuff like John's Mini Golf 2015. I made those last year, and just a bunch of signs, as you can see, all these signs from past years. Like this one, you may only play this hole if you got a hole one on the bonus hole. I mean, on the last hole. That was like for one of the bonus holes one year. You can only play it if you got a hole one the last hole. And no golf balls on dunes. That's a joke from like that was a hole from 2013, I believe, or 2012. It was like a beach hole, and there was like I got like shells from the beach, and I got plants like that like grow like near like the shore and stuff like that. And it just looked like I'm a beach hole, and so that's I had that sign there just as a joke, because you can't really walk on the dunes, as you guys know. So that's just like a joke. So yeah, here's like just some balls and fish food for the fish. Extra teas and just some other stuff that some stuff that used to be on the desk and on the main desk. I need to make new questions and comments box, because this one and this one are pretty much like worn out. As you can see, this one's like broken. So, and in here is pretty much just pens and stuff like that. And that's pretty much it for the main office. I covered most of the stuff in here. And now we can go over to the two bonus holes, because I only classify these two as bonus holes, but this one I don't really classify as a bonus hole. So this hole number 21, this hole took about a week to make. It was one of the longest. It took the longest time out of any of the holes in my course. A lot of thought process went into this. Oh, and look at who we have here. Anyway, I have a separate video just about this hole if you want some more information on it. But I can quickly go through this hole so that when you hit the ball, it goes up here. And the reason is the clock here is because when this ball come up, hit this, make a ding sound like the clock was like striking like 1 o'clock or something like that. Like you can move these around, it should be at 1 o'clock. And it just falls down, goes through here, through the pipe, and out there. Again, if you want some more information on this hole, you can watch a separate video. Here's the bonus hole, and it says if you get a hole one on this hole, you get a free ticket. So these two holes actually are the same ones from last year. I just kept them because these took me a long time, and why not just keep them anyway? So you hit it up here and you're trying to get through this middle hole right there, and it goes from that pipe and goes in. There's also like two other holes you can get into, and as you can see how like they all come down and connect. And then if you miss, it just goes back down, rolls back down, and hits off of this, and just like goes to the side. Now that was 23. I meant to do 22. Actually, these are actually out of order, because that's bonus hole one. This is bonus hole number two. So those should be like the numbers should be swapped. Anyway, so this one is again same thing as from last year, but I also forgot to mention. The only change from these holes is that all this wood you see, like that wood right there, is all painted white this year. It used to be just like regular wood, but I painted it white to make it look nicer. So what you want to try to do is like get it into like this last hole right here, and then it just like goes down through these nails and makes like cool little sounds, and then goes into the hole. And if you miss it, it falls in through one of these holes and then goes off one of the sides, just hits this and goes off onto the side.